called Family Quality TV Time. And every Sunday night at 7:30, my father made us watch this show called Mutual Omaha Wild Kingdom. Y'all remember that show? See, y'all remember the show was a good animal show. That's why some of y'all applaud, because it was a really good show. See, the show was terrifying to me, because my father would watch that show and figure out some of the different ways animals live, and then he would try to make us live the same way. See, sometimes he would see some of the principles of their lifestyle and then try to implement them into our lifestyle. And I'll never forget, when I was 12 years old, I was like 6 foot tall. My brother was 10, he was almost 6 foot tall. And my dad was only 1 foot nine. And we were down there watching this Wild Kingdom when they had a show on about the lions. And they say lions live in a pride, and there's only one male dominant. He's in charge of the whole pride. And my dad was, yeah! That's exactly how it is around here. Only one person can be in charge. Watch this, boys, y'all gonna learn something now. Then they got like 4 or 5 females. Their job, take care of the cubs. He was like, that's your mama's job. Make sure y'all get up in the morning, go to school, put your clothes on. I ain't got time for that. And then they got like 8 males. They do all the work. They do all the hunting and defending of the pride. And my dad looked at my brother and I said, see, that's y'all's job. Y'all the workers. Y'all do all the work, washing dishes, making beds. And we did all the work around. But my dad did no work. But every once in a while, one of the males in the pride would get fed up doing all the work. He would challenge the male dominant to a fight. If he wins, he becomes the male dominant. The loser must leave the pride. That's when my brother said, we need to take daddy out. I said, what are you saying? He said, just like the lions, man. If we beat up daddy, we can establish dominance in the house. We don't have to do no work. And at 12 and 10, we thought it was a good idea. And my brother looked at me and said, since you're the oldest, you go first. I said, what you gonna do? He said, as your younger brother, I got your back. Remember, daddy always said, whatever you do, I should always support you. So if you go first, I got your back, dog. No matter what, I will always support everything that you do. You're the oldest, and I appreciate you being older. So you make sure you go first, and I will bring up the rear. And we thought we could beat my father, because he was 1 foot 9. So we would never, I will never forget this as long as I live, folks. It was 100 degrees outside. It was humid, muggy, sticky. And my father, from the couch position, he looked at my brother and I said, when y'all come home from school today, cut the grass. My brother looked at me and said, today is the day. So I went to my mother and I kissed her on the forehead. She said, you never kiss me in the morning. I said, this could be my last morning. Because I knew how my dad was, and he told you to do something, you better do it. So when we got home from school, my mother was there. She said, your father told me to remind you boys to cut the grass. My brother jumped in, we don't cut the grass here no more. Isn't that right, Rodney? Yes. Cause I ain't gonna lie, I was scared to death. So my brother said, don't worry about it, man. We ain't cutting the grass. The line is drawn in the sand. So my father came home from work that night, 11 o'clock, the grass wasn't cut, he was upset. He said, look, didn't I tell those boys